Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So today we'll be looking at what the short-run cost curves of a firm look like when they're put on a graph. We'll be focusing mainly on the per unit costs, so things such as marginal cost, average variable cost, average fixed cost, and of course, average total cost, how to draw them on a graph, how to read them on a graph, and then how to use those curves to actually go ahead and calculate your total cost, all from just looking at it on a graph. With that said, let's get into it. So something you might see when you begin looking at cost curves in microeconomics is your total costs. And so you would start by learning that total fixed cost is simply a horizontal line set at whatever the fixed cost is. In this case, total fixed cost is $100. Now total variable cost looks something like this, and you'll notice that it gets steep really quickly as quantity increases or as output goes up. We also know that the total fixed cost plus the total variable cost is equal to the total cost, and therefore you'll notice that they have a similar slope. However, the total cost starts at a y-intercept of 100, which is where the total fixed cost is. And this means that for any given output or any given quantity, the difference between the total variable cost and the total cost will always be $100, because that's what the total fixed cost is. But what's much more useful and something that you'll spend a lot more time on when you're actually studying cost curves are the per unit costs. And you'll start by looking at something called the average fixed cost, which you can see starts off higher and then decreases as quantity increases. And this makes sense because the total fixed cost is a fixed number, but the average fixed cost is that total fixed cost divided by quantity. So the more and more and more quantity you produce, the smaller and smaller and smaller the average fixed cost will become, because you're taking a fixed cost and dividing it by more and more units. And then we have the marginal cost, which we know from a previous video is the cost of creating one additional unit. And this curve begins going down and then turns and steeply increases due to the law of diminishing returns. Next, we've got the average variable cost, and you'll notice it takes a U-shape, but it actually intersects the marginal cost curve at its exact minimum. And this means that if the marginal cost is ever less than the average variable cost, then the average variable cost must be decreasing. On the other hand, if the marginal cost is above the average variable cost, then the average variable cost must be increasing. And that just means that it intersects exactly at the average variable cost's minimum. Finally, we have the last per unit curve, which is the average total cost. And that's simply the sum of the average fixed cost and the average variable cost. So it takes on relatively the same shape as the average variable cost, but it sits a little bit higher. And the difference between those two curves is the amount of the average fixed cost. You'll notice that the marginal cost also intersects the average total cost at its minimum, and therefore the same principles apply, where when the marginal cost is less than the average total cost, the average total cost is decreasing, and when the marginal cost is greater than the average total cost, then the average total cost is increasing. So once we have these curves on the graph, how do we actually interpret them? How do we make sense out of them? What if our professor asks what the marginal cost of creating a sixth unit is? We would go to the quantity equals six, or output equals six on the bottom, follow it all the way up to the marginal cost curve, and then follow that along to the y-axis to see what the marginal cost is. And upon doing that, we see that it's $52. Similarly, we could do this for each of the cost curves. So the average total cost at six units is $36. The average variable cost for six units is $28. And finally, the average fixed cost of six units in this case is $8. Now keep in mind, as I mentioned before, the average total cost is the sum of the average variable cost and the average fixed cost. So what you'll notice is that these two values right here are the exact same. They're both $8. So the difference between $36 and $28, that is the difference between the average total cost and the average variable cost, is eight, and so is the difference between the average fixed cost and the x-axis. This will always be the case. So as the AFC asymptotes towards the x-axis, the ATC will asymptote towards the AVC, making that gap between them smaller and smaller. As promised, we'll also explore the final thing that you can do with these curves, and that is to interpret what the total costs are just by looking at the averages. So recall that the formula for average total cost is the total cost divided by Q. Well, then if we reverse that equation, the total cost is equal to the average total cost times Q. And in this case, the total cost would be equal to $36 times 6, which is just the average total cost times quantity, and that's equal to $216. So we can actually calculate the total cost at 6 units just by multiplying the ATC times Q. So now we know that the total cost of 6 units of output is $216, but we want to know how much of that is variable cost and how much of that is fixed cost. So we can use the same types of formulas to solve for that. So recall that total variable cost is equal to average variable cost times quantity. At a quantity of 6, the average variable cost is $28, and 28 times 6 is 168. Finally, we apply these same principles to the average fixed cost to calculate the total fixed cost. Total fixed cost is equal to the AFC times Q, so the average fixed cost at a quantity of 6 is $8. $8 times 6 is equal to $48. Now, to make sure that we've not messed up any of our algebra, we can actually cross-check this and make sure that the TVC plus the TFC equals the total cost. And so checking that math, we discover that 168 plus 48 is in fact 216, and therefore we haven't made any errors in our math. We really hope that this sheds a light on the cost curves and helps you read them as well as interpret them when you're looking at them on a graph. If you haven't checked out our other video on costs of production, then it would really help to do so. And of course, if you found them helpful, then let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and of course, comment what sort of economic topics or homework questions you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.